dimension Neptunia V2.
Hi everyone. Can you all hear me? Okay, perfect. So it seems that this might have a bit of a 10-second delay. So if I'm looking at the comments, I'll be having a 10-minute delay, just to put it out there. Just give me a moment and I'll begin playing and taking all your answers. Okay, everything's fine. So, how's everyone doing? Okay, I think I'm set to go. Well then, greetings everyone. My name is Ladycroft VR and welcome to my first live Q&A stream. I'm glad you guys could make it. I was going through the comments before starting right now and I saw that some people were waiting like 5 hours since I launched the event. So thank you so much for waiting. I'm happy you guys could make it. Anyway, before I begin, I just wanted to say a few rules before this. Wait, no, don't start. Okay. So, I want this to be a very friendly environment for everyone and enjoyable as possible. So, I'm gonna ask you guys to not do any rude comments, insults towards me or any other people here in the comments. I don't want you guys spamming or advertising anything. Otherwise, YouTube is going to recognize that and delete it out of the comments. And most importantly, don't make any rude questions to me or too personal. Just keep them simple. Like I said, I'm gonna answer as much as I can, but don't do anything rude comments, all right? And so without any further ado, let's begin. So if you saw my last video, the emotional one, I said that I was gonna be doing this live Q&A while playing the Mill and Arthur DLC. Now, Mill and Arthur is a new character in the Neptunia series based on Square Enix card game Mill and Arthur. So we're gonna get to know here her story and everything about her, just play as her. So yeah. So feel free now to leave your questions and I'll answer them while I play this. Okay, so the first question is by the Mad Hater. Hatter? Sorry. What got you into Neptunia? Well, what really got me into this was that one day I was going to the PlayStation store from my PS Vita. And so I decided to just look out for the games that there were in the store. And then suddenly I spot the first Rebirth game, and I got really interested in. Sorry about that. And I thought it looked really awesome. I decided, well, why not give it a try? So I went to the first GameStop near me to buy it. And so yeah, the moment I began playing it, I couldn't stop. I spent so many hours playing it, and I still do. I still spend a lot of hours playing this game. So yeah, that's specifically what got me into the series. Okay, next question is by by Joseph Cordova. What's your favorite net game? I think it would be Rebirth 1. I really like the story. It was the first one that got me into the series. I thought the characters were very well portrayed. I got to know a lot about them. Like, I really like the game a lot. So far, that's the game that I spent the most hours playing. So yeah, it would definitely be Rebirth 1, my first game. Alright, I pictured the scene. Okay, next question is by Photon Dragon 02. When making AMVs, how do you decide what song to use? Oh, that's a very interesting question. It really depends. I usually just listen to songs and I try to look for the ones that have more meaning into them, not just really a random one. And depending if it goes a little bit with the story of the Neptunia or to any of the characters, then that's specifically when I decide to what song to use. Then I just start editing to see how it goes. If I don't think the song fits them, then I just change it, or at least keep a little bit of the scenes, but then decide to take on another song. So yeah, that's specifically how I choose the songs for the net videos. Alright, the next question is by Adult Neptune. Have you played Fire Emblem games? I have not. Oh gosh. Okay, no, I have not played any of those games, though I really wanted to, especially since I saw the last one that it seemed really interesting, the new one for the DS. But no, so far I have not played any of the games. I only know some of the characters from Smash Bros, so no, sorry, I have not played the game yet. Okay, before I continue with the questions, I just have to say I'm really surprised by the amount of people that are here right now. I was expecting, like, I don't know, like 10 people right now in the streaming, and as I'm looking at the count, it's up to 100, so this is exciting. Thank you guys so much. I didn't know so many of you wanted to see the stream, so yeah, this is gonna be really fun. Okay, anyway, what's the next question? Let's see. How do you get so many subs? my Moonlight Howlers anime lover. How do I get many? Well, you're gonna have to blame Nober for that. I think he was the one who got me most of the subscribers that I currently have. I believe it has been through the crack videos. But yeah, I believe that most of the subscribers here came from Noble's reaction to his two videos. So yeah. Okay. No, I'm stuck. Okay. Okay, so next question by XXLootX. Who is your least favorite Neptunia character? The least? Okay, that's gonna have to be Adnes from Rebirth 3. I'm not sure if she appeared in Victory, for the one for the PlayStation 3, so... No! No, God, I'm so sorry! No, but I think my least favorite character will be her. She is really annoying. She's really annoying in that game, and I honestly don't like her too much. Other than her, I don't know. No, I don't. Other than her, I don't think I dislike any other character. Oh gosh, I was too focused on the questions. I didn't notice that Kompa was dying. I'm so sorry, Doctor! No, I can reach. There we go. Anyway. Let me guess. Okay, next question. By Ombination96. Hi, Lady Croft. Can you guess who I am? Of course I can. You're the you're the lovely girl who made the two fanarts on my and shared them on my Twitter channel. So yeah, thank you very much. Of course I would recognize you. okay. Wait, I gotta get it. No. One moment. Can I? Yes. Okay, I can. Okay, next question. By Solar. He asks, least favorite NEP game? Least favorite? Honestly, I can't say. So far, I really like all the NEP games. They're really fun, but if I had to choose the one who I prefer the least, then I don't know. I think it would have to be then Neptunia U. And it's not because I hate the game, but it was just too much fan service for me. Now, don't hate me. I know that for the guys that must be a heaven, but I'm not really that fan of the of fan service, so I wasn't really happy when every time that their clothes would get ripped. So yeah. But I don't hate the game. Just that little aspect of the game. Oh my gosh. No, why do I get stuck so many times? Okay, I know I said that we were going to get to know Mew and Arthur, but I just really wanted to do a quick vice versa. Come on, die already. Okay, wait that. Okay, the next question is by Hyper Dimension Bliss. Which crack was the most fun to make? Also, have you played Monster Hunter game? Okay, well, the crack that I had the most fun doing definitely has to be the fourth one. I had way too much fun making that one. Like, I had a lot of new things to try out. In fact, there's actually a lot of stuff that I was practicing while editing them. Like, for example, for those of you who saw it, the Uni slash Hanzo combo. That's the first time I had actually made that kind of move in editing them. So yeah, and that along with other things like the Noir screen. So yeah, I have to say that was really the most fun I've had doing, and I believe the fifth one is gonna be even more fun since I already have a few things I would like to try and that they seem fun to do. So yeah, as for the Monster Hunter, no, I have not. I was actually going to, well, I actually got interested since I saw the third one, but no, so far I have not played the games, though I would really like to play them someday. So yeah, thank you for the question. Just give me a second here. Okay, we got everything. By the way, the stream is going to run for approximately maybe 2 hours and a half. So I decided to add the other half because I didn't know if this was gonna be 2 hours, if it was gonna be okay. So yeah, I decided to add 30 more minutes to it. Okay, now here in the guild, that little exclamation button that's appearing there is to start the Mew and Arthur story. So I'm one that really likes reading dialogues and hearing them. So I'm gonna take pauses between the dialogue that they talk to answer the questions. All right, so let's begin. Okay, that's exactly what I say every time I'm going to make a crack video. I say I have motivation and I'm gonna get them done. Yet again, I never do. Okay, let's see in the questions. Okay, the question by Fonton Dragon 02. Any AMVs you're making? Okay, well, so far, No, so far I am not making any AMVs, though I was actually listening to a few songs the other days. Like I said, I like getting into the songs and getting to know the lyrics of the songs, so just to choose the songs that I'm gonna use for an AMV, but so far I am not working on one, though I might actually work on one maybe, I don't know, like by August or something. So yeah, for now I am not, but I might get into that. Another question, boom, by Bomb? Boom? No, Boom, sorry. Do you love IF? How did you know? Oh my gosh! How did you know that I love IF? Yes, by this point, I believe a lot of you in my Twitter or any of my social medias, I do like posting. Oh, there she is. Yes, I do really like IF. She's an amazing character and so far my favorite. I'm gonna describe her later why I really like her, but yeah, I do love IF. Okay.
それにしても結構歩いたわね。ここいるで少し休む？
Okay, so we have also a another mysterious character there. Good to know.
そうだな。お主も疲れているだろ。
Oh yeah, by the way, fun fact. For those of you who like watching animes in Japanese, the girl who does, well, actually the one who does the voice actress of Mill and Arthur is the same one who does the voice of Shino in Is the Order a Rabbit and Hestia from Danmachi. Just a fun fact out there for those of you who like the Japanese voice actresses. Okay, so next question is by Duke D. Favorite villain? Well, depends. Oh, Neptune, you just had to barge in. So for my favorite villain, well, depends. If we're talking about here in the games of Neptunia, I don't know, it would have to be Anoni Death. Just by being evil, he's really funny. Yeah, but if we're talking about other stuff, then well, I'm actually gonna mention it non-anime, but it's actually the evil queen Regina from Once Upon a Time. For those of you who have watched the series of ABC, then yeah, she has to be my other my other favorite villain. That's Scream. She just left her. Okay. Oh, it was a monster. Okay, next question by Evil Michael 997. Who is your favorite goddess? Mine is Puria. Oh, well, that's nice to know. My favorite goddess, well. Sorry, press the button. Oh, Neptune. Okay, so my favorite goddess, it would have to be Vert. So far, she's my favorite goddess of all, and it's based most on personality. I really like her, how cute she is, how kind, and I also like that gamer side of her. But yet again, she's also really cool when she transforms into her HDD. But a lot of you are just telling me that Noir is the best. But yeah, but no, but Blonde is also my second favorite one, followed by Neptune and then Noir. I'm sorry, Noir. I still love you. But yeah, Vert is definitely my favorite, number one goddess. Oh, Neptune, I do the same. I always enter the dungeons without knowing what level they are on, and then as I start fighting, suddenly my life just goes down and I go game over. And I know that I just lost 1 hour of gameplay, so don't feel so bad. Yeah, that's quite the motivation you got there. Next question by Black Fat Man 41. Do you know Filthy Frank? Oh my goodness, please no. Don't ask me if I know that guy. Unfortunately, yes I do. By the way, I don't hate him. I don't have anything. I don't have. anything against him, but he's just a weird guy, and one of my best friends really, really likes him. Like, that's his motivation in life, and it just creeps me out a bit when he gets too much into that freaking character of his. So, yes, I do know about Filthy Frank, but I'm not proud to say that I do know about him. Yeah, two against one isn't fair, but come on, you're Neptune. You can take five of them at a time. A million to the rescue. Rumor street heal? What? Okay. Let's see. Another question by Pathmaster. Since IF is your favorite character, what's your story with her? Oh gosh. You ask me like I've been in the games with her. My story with her, I'd have to speak a little bit about when I played the first one. By the time I was playing it, you know, I was getting into the characters. I was like, oh, Neptune's cool, Compass really cool too. Oh gosh, no, please. Anyway, so at the time that Ivy appeared, I remember her. She was actually, at the first I was confused about what to feel about her, because she was just like, oh, what are you little girls doing here? You shouldn't be here, like, I'm the best at this. Like, at the first she was that type of character. I was like, nah, not really liking her. But as I progressed with the games and started playing a lot as her, and got to know her even better, especially in the second one and all the others, then I really started liking her character. She's very caring, she's very hardworking, she's smart, intelligent, and there's a lot of qualities about her that also resemble me. So yeah, she's definitely my favorite character. And, well, that will have to be my story with her, so, maybe? By the way, what Neptune just said right now, that it looked like something came out of a card, that's exactly what I said at the beginning of the stream, that Melee and Arthur is based off a card game from Square Enix. So come on, Neptune, don't start breaking the fourth wall. My blade? What blade? Okay, so she believes she's a king. How nice. Okay, sorry. So another question by Roaming Moon. Okay, I'll remember, Million, don't worry. Another question by Romy Moon. Do you hope that Hyperdimension Neptunia anime gets another season? Honestly? I'm sorry, I just keep pressing the button out of conscience. I'm just so used to that. Anyway, I would really like if there was another season, like, especially now with Mega Dimension Neptunia V2, like, there's a lot to the story and much things that they could do. So I would really love if there was a second season, but I think there might not be another, since I'm pretty sure that I read that the sales for the DVD as well as the anime weren't so good in Japan. So if it was for me, yes, I would really love to have another season, but that's hard. I don't think there's gonna be another, but let's not lose hope. Let's not lose it. Oh hey, she's been added to the party. Great. Alright. First fight! Let me just... Bad blue dragon! There it goes. Ow! Okay, next question by Expired Netball. Do you prefer the English or Japanese voices of the game? Also, hi! Oh, hi, Expired Netball. Well, as you can see now that I'm playing the game, I really enjoy the Japanese voices. Now don't get me wrong, I'm not hating on the other on the English voices, but I really prefer the Japanese more. I think they have more of a funny feel into them. Whoa! Oh, look at that! But yeah, I definitely prefer a lot the Japanese voice of the game, especially Neptune's. It's really funny how she goes from her quirky, funny voice into her HDD slash mature voice. So yeah, I really do enjoy the Japanese ones a bit more than the English ones. Be-do-do-ding! I really love that little sound. In fact, I was actually considering getting that level up sound to make it as my every time I receive a text that appears, because I really like it. Okay, anyway. I know, right? Who knew that Neptune could be such a great fighter? anyway, PPG Angel asks, can we be friends, Lady Croft? Of course! I'm always up for being friends with everyone. Right now, I want to feel like I'm a friend to all of you. So if you ever need anyone to talk to through social medias or anything, sure, we can be friends. I have nothing against that. Especially since I don't have any real friends here right now. I only have two best friends, and that's about it. So yeah, we can be friends. Of course. It's the epitome of a quest and of a Neptunia game, fighting with all the strangers you can find in the game. Okay, so another question by Marina Rocha asks, long hair Neb or short hair Neb? Ah, you're referring to adult or normal Neb? Neptune. Well, I like the long hair Neptune one. I have to say, it makes her look, well, that's more than obvious, but it makes her look more mature and, I don't know, prettier. I don't have anything against the short Neb one, but yeah, I definitely prefer a lot more the long hair Neb. So yeah, that's my answer. Yes, she must. Where was she? I totally forgot about her. I mean, there was monsters and Neptune was the damsel in distress, so we just have to save her. Okay, another question by Kind Carl. He asks, since Pokemon is a big deal this year, do you have a favorite Pokemon? I'm gonna get so much hate after answering this question. See, I said it, she was being attacked. Anyway, any favorite Pokemon? I'm gonna be honest, I have never played any of the Pokemon games. I have never watched the animes or the series. I'm sorry, so I can't say that I have a favorite one. But no, I'm actually not gonna. I was gonna say Pikachu, but you know what? That was gonna be too cliche for someone who doesn't know Pokemon, but no, I'm sorry. I don't even have Pokemon Go. I don't even get out of my house. Well, not when I'm in vacation, so. So yeah, sorry. So far, I don't have any favorite Pokemons. Now, don't hate me. Oh, is that so, Million? Did you just help Neptune because she's cute? Quirky hoodie. Oh great, so Millen is that type of character. She's the Uzume type of character too. Okay, next question by Shika Hakosaki. Shika, what are you doing here? Anyway, she asks, your first anime, as in the first ever anime you have ever seen. Oh gosh. What a question you ask. It's actually funny. Well, if we're talking about like an anime that I sat down to watch, and I'm gonna tell you the story because it's really funny. A girl just like you see. So I was in 10th grade, it was one of those last school days, and then suddenly everyone decided to just use one of the big screens that they have in the classrooms to put some animes, and the first thing that they put is High School of the Dead. I can still remember how creeped out I was to seeing all those women just running around all bloody, and I don't know, I was so creeped out by that. Of course, I never finished it. I only watched it another day, and I was like, oh no, hell no, I'm just creeped out by this. So that was the first anime per se that I ever watched. If we're talking about the first anime that I saw fully, then it would have to be School Days. And I'm not proud to say that, but it was School Days. And for those of you who have watched it, then you're gonna know exactly why I answer this way. So, Chikama! Oh cool, anyway, so yeah, High School of the Dead was my first anime ever. Not proud to say that. Yeah, pay her some mind. Neptune, she's told you! Come on! Oh my gosh! Wow, Neptune, you have just reached a new low. Yeah, she's definitely confused. Come on, Neptune. Okay, another question by PZ. I like cookies. What cookie is your favorite cookie? Okay, it would have to be chocolate chip cookies. Yeah, those are pretty much also the ones that I eat. So yeah, it would have to be chocolate cookies. And by the way, she's from Britain. Do I have any viewers right now from Britain? I think I do. I saw someone before the live stream began, that someone was waiting at 11 p.m. for the stream to watch. So if you're still here, then awesome. Arthur. Oh nice, they're all cool. Oh, that's actually pretty cool. 1 million? 1 million Arthurs? Oh hey, look! I do have people from England here. Awesome! And from Canada and Germany, nice! Nice, thank you guys so much for watching! Yep, she was definitely on top of the million to be called Million Arthur. Okay, next question by Bulbasaur Gaming. Will you ever go to any conventions to meet up with fans? Oh gosh. what a question. Well, I do go to conventions here where I'm from. However, I live in a very little island. So for those of you who are wondering what the PR means in the next to the Lady Croft, is where I'm from. It's Puerto Rico. So I live in a very small island. So for now, I don't think I have that much audience here. I also don't I also don't think, as myself, someone who has... I like prefer having supporters more than fans. I don't know, maybe it's a weird thing to say, but I mean, if in the future I do have more supporters or fans, so to say, I would really love to meet all of them. Like I said, I want to make friends. I like being friends with everybody, so would I go to a convention for that? Sure, why not? I would really like to meet other people. Of course, I expected no less from you, Million. Oh, she's a candidate. Not even the full thing. $1 million nephews. Would that be a good thing or a bad thing? Well, I think if there was a nation with 1 million nephews, that would be the most responsible / tech thing ever. Okay, let's see. Question by Blue Moon 11211. What games do you play besides the Neptune ones? Ah, I play a lot of them. Let's see this. Oh, nice. Anyway, well, right now I'm playing a lot of Overwatch. I don't know, I got really hooked into that game. So I play those types of games. I also like playing racing games such as Forza and the Need for Speed ones. I like puzzle games a lot. For example, those that are... the more of the classic ones from the Tomb Raider. I also play Uncharted. For shooters, I believe I play more Halo. So I actually play a little bit of everything except in PC, because unfortunately I do not have one, but I would get into playing more PC games. But yeah, I play a little bit of everything. Just the other days I was playing Beyond Two Souls, and oh my goodness, that game. That's for now Overwatch, a lot of it, but I do play a little bit of everything. We know, Neptune, you've been reminding us that for the past, I don't know, 10 games? What? Yep. Okay, next question by the Mad Hatter, again. Who is your favorite Overwatch character? Mine is Hanzo. My favorite character? Mercy! That's right, people. I like being the supporter, the doctor. Definitely Mercy has to be my favorite character in this. I use her pretty much almost on all of the games. I'm just more of the people who likes keeping others alive while they do the objectives. So yeah, more of a Mercy. If not Mercy, then Soldier 76, Tracer. I began using Pharah the other days, and I'm doing pretty good with her, but definitely Mercy is my favorite. Oh no, please don't transform, you don't need to prove that. Telepathic. Or you just take out the plan in Planet Tune and you just get her name. A CPU. Well, because I bought the DLC and she better come with us in the party. Okay, next question is by Miko Dust MC. Have you ever heard of Love Life? Oh my goodness. Of all the questions you could have asked, can you ask Love Life? I'm just kidding, there's nothing bad about it. Yes, I have heard of Love Live. I do play Love Live, and I have seen the animes and read the mangas. So, yeah, I definitely heard of Love Live, and that game destroyed my life with that stupid little game. By the way, my favorite character is Rin. If you look into my channel or in any of my social medias, you're gonna see that in my banner. There's a picture of Neptune and another girl to the side, and that is Rin. So yeah, she's my favorite character in the series. Yes, we can support each other during battles. Oh my goodness. Yes, she is. No, that would be his nephew. Don't count on Neptune too much. Okay, let's see. Forever Young Darius, have you ever heard over Lost Puce? What's Lost Puce? By the way, it's spelled P-U-C-E. Oh my gosh, I just saw the irony in the comment. So she wrote over I don't know how to say it, but yeah. Okay, we're talking about Lost Puce. Yes, I've heard of him. I've heard of him from his two reactions to my videos. So yeah. Yeah, it's not convenient for Neptune. No, and it's not even convenient for you having Neptune in your party. Oh, don't lie. Okay, so Rocket Crush asks, do you hate Pharah as much as I do? No, I don't hate Pharah. Yeah, it's really easy, I know, right? Convincing Neptune is super easy. No, I don't hate Pharah. She's actually a pretty awesome character to use for when it comes to defending. Especially when you want to escape from those ground attacks from Reinhardt, John Cred and many others, so no, I'm sorry, I don't hate Pharah as much as you do. I don't even hate her. You're welcome. No, you won't be a bother. I need more people in this party. Okay. Millie! Sure, let's call him Millie. Okay, so Lyrica Diva of Limboss asks, Lady Croft, what do you think of the Conquest ending of Rebirth 2? Please do not ask me that. I don't... What do I think of it? It was shocking, okay? That was a very shocking ending. And I don't want to give spoilers here for anyone who has not played the game and or has not gotten the Conquest endings, but that ending really gives a big twist into the series. So what do I think of it? Well, like I said, it was surprising. I don't know, I can't say anything more about it. Chikama! Yay! Now where's Chikama? Add her to the party too. Okay, before I continue to any more story whatever thingy. Oh, that's right. Let me check on the scouts. Let's see. Okay, so this is a little bit... It's a little bit like one I answered before, but Code Mirai asks, how would you feel if a second season of Neptunia was announced? Well, I would be jumping, screaming, and anything from emotion. I would really love it for there to be a second season of the game. So, yeah, I would definitely feel excited and curious at the same time to see what they would bring to the story. Oh, hello, older brother. Hey, a scout! Bancho! You know what? It looks like Mako from Kill la Kill. Oh, another one! More people! Ah, you useless bunch. And okay, next question. Oh guys, okay, who's your favorite CPU or CPU candidate? Mine is Snapdragon. Well, as I answered before. Oh yeah, the question is by Nanoha Takamachi. My favorite, like I said, my favorite CPU is Spurt. So my favorite CPU candidate, it's between Netgear and Uni. Depends, if we're talking about personalities and all that, I'm gonna go with Netgear. But at the same time, I really like Uni. I think she's really awesome and her tsundere personality is a little bit funnier. A little bit funnier than Noir's. Because, well, it's very light. At the same time, it isn't that light. So, I'm gonna go with Uni. Yeah, I'm gonna go with Uni. I think I prefer her a little bit, just a tiny bit more than Netgear. Okay, next question by Anime Heroful. Do you think that the Hyperdimension Neptunia series should have their own crossover game or be in one? Well, actually, great news for you! Just recently, well actually a couple of months ago, Idea Factory announced a new game called Super Dimension Neptune vs. Sega Hargirls, which is going to be a crossover game between Hyperdimension Neptunia and Sega Hargirls, which is, it might be the equivalent to Hyperdimension Neptunia, but from Sega. It's not going to feature all the characters, all the original characters from the Hyperdimension Neptunia series, but there's definitely gonna be some of them, Neptune, Plutia, Ify being one of them. So yeah, I think that's a crossover game that I'm really looking forward to, specifically because Ify is the main character. But yeah, that if you mean like a full crossover game, then yeah, I would really like to see, or I think Idea Factory might do one sometime, or Compile Heart. Oh my gosh, come on! Super rabbit. Okay, next question by Chica! Stop asking me questions! I'm just kidding. Do you support the ship I've burnt? Oh my gosh. Do I support it? I mean, I don't fully support it, but I think it's a very funny, it's quite a peculiar ship. Oh look, a hidden treasure. Do I fully support it? Maybe a little, just because of how funny it is that Bert acts toward Ify. Well, okay, for those of you who are wondering, because this was not seen in the anime, in the first Rebirth game, Bert has this huge affection towards Ify for some weird reason, and like to the point that she stalks her, hugs her a lot, calls her cute names, and seduces her. But do I fully support it? Maybe. I'm not exactly one to look for ships in games or animes, but oh sure, why not? It's a funny ship. So many! Attack my Neptune! Okay. Oh, let's see. Another question by Pathmaster. This is a question for everybody. What do you think about crossover between Neptunia and Mega Man Battle Network? Well, there you go, people. Answer him the question. Him, her, sorry. What do I think about it? Sounds pretty cool. I definitely look forward to it. Oh gosh. Why does he go so far? Okay, Yuki asks, who is best girl and why is it Yumio? I don't think Yumio counts as a girl or even a full man, as he is a damn fish. Who is best girl? Well, for me, it's definitely Ify. Ify all the way. But why is it Yumio? I don't know. Do you consider Yumio a best girl? I don't know. Ah, okay, let's go. Okay, so Forever Yandere asks, what is your favorite nep on crack? Well, it's definitely the fourth one. Like I said before, it was the most fun I had doing. And this is, for me, it's actually the funniest one. Because while editing, I was even laughing a lot throughout the video. And just at the things that I was doing, so... Wait a second. Okay, there we go. Let's have Milin, the leader of the party. So yeah. Ah! I didn't see it! Okay, Destroyer's Ghost asks, which do you prefer, plot or justice? Justice reigns from above! No, I'm just kidding. Yeah, I definitely prefer... Oh my gosh, you know what? Actually, it depends. I don't know, I'm gonna take justice. Oh, look, Sampa leveled up! I think I prefer a little bit more justice over plot. Just because in the plot you already have the concept of what the story is and just that, so then you would just have to know how to resolve that, the problem to that plot. So in between the justice, you just see how it begins developing, how it's gonna get resolved somehow, and specifically more of the the motivation that the characters have, which usually, I really like the motivation for when trying to bring justice, especially here in the first Neptunia game. I'm talking about the one for the PS3 that came out in 2010. We have this character, Nisa, who she is a really big fan of being justice and all that. So yeah, I would have to prefer a little bit more justice over plot. Okay, let's go to another place. The enemies here are not that challenging for me. Alright, treasure! Where's the treasure? I forgot how to put the map. Okay, there we go. One moment. Oh, there it is! Treasure, come to me! Oh, dang it. I forgot where it was! No, I forgot it! I'm sorry, I'm such a klutz, I keep forgetting where I saw it. Okay, sound that- no! Stupid monster. Okay, anyway, Lady Crow by UberUmbrination96. Lady Crow, have you ever watched Madoka Magica? And if so, what do you think of Kyubei? Oh my gosh! Thank you so much for the question. Yes, in fact, Madoka Magica is my all-time favorite anime. Like my number one, for those of you wondering. So what do I think of Kyubei? Well, first of all, I don't care if he's a he or if he's a she, but I hate it. I hate it with all my heart for all that he has done, that thing has done, and will continue doing. So yeah, there's definitely a lot of hate in my heart towards that thing. Sorry for those of you who like that thing. I really despise / hate it. So yeah. So yeah, that's definitely my favorite anime, so don't be surprised if you do see a reference in the next crack video with that anime. Because by the way, for those of you who have seen it, the voice of Miki Sayaka, the Japanese voice actress, is the same voice actress of Yuni here. So yeah, that's a fun fact out there for those of you who didn't know. I'm on Neptune! Okay, Ivan Garcia asked, have you ever played an RPG from Atlus? Oh gosh, okay, Atlus. I can't recall one right now. Yeah, no, I'm sorry. I can't recall a game made by Atlus right now. So yeah, sorry about that. Sorry that I can't fully answer your question. But I don't know, maybe I do know. I just don't remember. So no! Okay, darn it. No, I don't remember, sorry. By the way, this map is a pretty tricky one. It's, as you can see, it's really based off on Mario. And every time you lose or you fall, you lose like this this life, a little life. So since I just felt that I only had one life, so I just wanted to get out of there and regain another life. No! Darn it, I make so many mistakes while playing this. Stupid little ghosties. Okay, I feed you your thing. Okay! Miko Dust MC asks, have you ever played Persona 4? Yes, I have! In fact, just the other day, I was playing on my Xbox 360 and I thought for a moment, what games could I play? And then I began playing Persona 4 again. If we're talking about which characters I use, then it would have to be Chie? Satonaka? I'm sorry if I don't say the name correctly. I'm not really good with Japanese names and all that, but yeah, I definitely have played Persona 4, but Justice! But I have not seen the anime yet. I want to finish actually the story of Persona 4 first and then watch the anime. Okay, this is really tricky. I tried doing this just the other day, but you see all those little things that are falling? If I touch just one of those, my life goes... Okay, I accidentally went back and fell. Oh my gosh. No! But anyway, this map is really complicated right now. I'm trying to be super cautious about it. Oh my gosh. Oh, YOLO! I'm gonna come on! This is really tricky. I don't know how to pass this. No! Okay, you know what? I give up. I'm sorry, people. I'm gonna go away from this map right now. What was the other complicated one? In fact, let's just go to the story. No! Okay, Otaku okay, it's spelled life with a 5 in it. Have you played the new Tomb Raider? Yes, I have! In fact, I even bought the limited edition for the Xbox, of course. And I really, really love the game. And everything about it, I like the exploring side, the scenery, everything about the game, so... Well... Oops, I accidentally used compass power in this one, but yeah, I definitely played it, and I really like the game. I have yet to find all the treasures from the game. The secrets, but yeah, I definitely played it. And I would play it again 10 times, because it really is an amazing game. Okay, so Thrills809 asks, have you ever played Project Diva? Well, I have played the demo, the one from the PS Vita. But if I fully played one, no. I was going to buy one of the versions for... Oh, sorry. I was going to buy one of the versions for the PS3, but my PS3 unfortunately died. a while ago, so yeah. I wish I could. Maybe once I'll actually get to buy a game of Project Diva, but for now, unfortunately, I have not. I have not fully played of one of those games. By the way, I'm actually gonna continue the story. It seems like there's gonna be a few more of Mille and Arthur once I progress the story, I believe. So I hope you guys don't mind. So far, the story here in here, just to not give too much spoilers, is that people have forgotten that Neptune is a CPU, and along with the help of Kampa and Ifin, Neptune is trying to find a way to defeat this bad guy, to say it like that, and to regain her power as a CPU, and you know, and to gain control of her nation again. So, no, not much spoilers. Let's go ahead and see. Right now, we're gonna see that Neptune is home. Neptune, are you not supposed to be helping Vert? What are you doing here, girl? No, she's not fine. Anyway, the boss asks, well, Lady Croft, notice me, please. I got a big question. Okay, I have noticed you. I cannot promise I'll hold on into that noticing, since there are a lot of questions popping up, but sure, leave your question and see if I can, and I'll see if I can answer it. You're all fine and dandy. Oh yeah, right, you just came back. Anyway, Adult Neptune asks, have you ever heard of Xenoblade Chronicles? Of course I have! I even want to buy the... I also want to buy the new version for the Wii U. I have not played any of the games so far, but... yeah, I've heard of the series and I would really, really like to play it. It seems like a really fun game, so let's see if one day I get it. What's going on is that you people got beat in a fight. That's what happened. Well, Ivy's actually the future CPU. Well, you know what? I actually counted. Neptune is a CPU candidate after all. Welcome back, Neptune. You weren't that much of a help back when I was playing with Verb, but sure, nice to have you. Yeah, Noir is actually being chased by a Yandere right now. I can already tell you that. No need to ask Neptune. Let's see what else we got in here. Black Knight 88 asks, have you ever heard of Medaka Box? I've actually heard about it, though I haven't really given it thought or known much about it, so I cannot promise that I fully heard it or anything, but I've heard of it. I've heard of the game or series so far. I'll actually look more into it later, but yeah, to answer your question, I've heard of it. Like I said, Neptune, don't worry. Noir's already been taken care of from a Yandere. That's all you need to know. She's fine. That's right, she's trying to break her out of the hands of a psycho. I'm not meaning to give any spoilers, guys, but if you did saw the crack anime 4, you're gonna see that in a part you see this girl that shouts, I love senpai, yes I do, she's for me, not for you. And oh sorry, he. And that was actually Kesha. She's a new character here in the game. And I'm not gonna give spoilers about her, but she's the new Yandere from the series. Like I said, not much spoilers if you already saw the fourth crack video. Don't you lie, Neptune, I already found Blonde and she's fine. Oh gosh. Yeah, there's definitely a panic in Planet Toon in any way you look at it, in every game and even in the dang anime. Oh, anyway, look at this ironic question. Kesha Gold Third of Last Station asks, am I scary? Oh, by the way, yeah, that's actually a user here in the comments. You're kind of scary. I remember playing the first time in the story, and I just got surprised by your personality, so yes, I'm a bit scared about you. You're just like Plutia, you know, you have this soft and scary side at the same time. It's Nevier, what the heck do you expect about it? That girl knows more than Dengekiko. By the way, those of you who don't know what Dengekiko means, it's actually a Japanese magazine that gives news about gaming and well, I think it's gaming news and announcements. And she's also a character here in the Hyperdimension Neptunia series, who's always giving out news and everything about what's going on in people's lives. So yeah. Yes, Keisha, you're a bit funny. You are kind of funny. Because Nevier is all tech and techie. Okay, so let's see. So Zero Legend asks, how old are you? You know what, I actually don't want to give my full age. But let's just say I'm in my 20s. I'm somewhere there in my my 20s. I just don't want to give my age. I don't know. I don't want to seem old. So no, I'm just gonna say I'm in my 20s. the pride. Yes, you're my fee. Oh my gosh, I just found it funny how she said my pride as a guild member. No, don't start. Yes, sir. Yes, the siblings have to be feared sometimes. Oh, how funny. No, she's not exaggerating. You're actually... You're actually much smarter in some aspects. Okay, Zero Dimension is what is the chapter that happened before this one. So yeah, I'm not gonna give spoilers about that, but yeah, something happened, and I can understand why Nevier wanted to do what she's doing now. Anyway. Let's see. Oh, I saw a pretty good question here. Okay, XX Loot asks, who is your favorite Gold Third member? Wait. Oh, don't worry, that girl is gonna do fine by herself. Just give her video games, anime, and anything, and she'll do fine. She'll find a way to get everything better. By the way, my favorite Gold Third member, I cannot. Okay, it's Sisha. Sisha. From the blonde story. Yeah, it definitely has to be Sisha. She was such an amazing character, a really interesting one to play as, and I don't know, I really enjoy her personality and everything, and even her will to fight for Louis despite everything that was going on. So yeah, so far she's my favorite one. Just to ask, how are you guys enjoying the stream right now? I don't know if it's doing fine, if I'm going too slow here on the game. So just let me know. I'm just curious. Yes, because if you abandon it would just get worse, Neptune. We get it. Or I have an idea. Just send your little sister. Trust me, you're my option. Just send Nevier. See, Neptune starts hearing me. Anyway, I knew this because it already happened here in the game. Okay, I'm happy. I'm happy that the streaming's is getting better. Okay, the boss. I'm sorry. I have not seen your answer. Just ask again. I'll try to catch it. But before that. Yes, you, Nevier. Go help her. She doesn't have a CPU. And she goes very along with you. Anyway, Yuke DS, do you like the Infamous games? Yes, I do. Yeah, but Neptune doesn't notice her anyway, you know. That's exactly why I added in the crack videos this Notice Me Senpai segment, because Neptune doesn't want her. Anyway, back to the question. Yes, I do like the Infamous games. They're really fun. I especially like those kinds of games where you have superpowers and you can just do whatever you want, like doing big jumps and have super awesome powers. I cannot say that I've played the second Infamous game yet, but I did got to play the first one, and the new one, Second Son. I was a few trophies away from getting the platinum, but it was my friend's game, so I had to give it back to him. But it was truly a fun game. And for those of you who say that it's a short game, it took me like a month to actually get it done completely. But yeah, I like the games. They're really, really fun. Yes, I'm sure she really wanted to get back with Neptune, but guess what? Neptune doesn't care because she's a terrible senpai slash sister. Oh, I'm not hating on her. But it's something only she can do. No, I mean, Ivy can also help Vern. Compa could also help Vern. Why does it have to be Neptune, Neptune? Really, why does it have of all people to be Neptune? In fact, call out Broccoli. Broccoli is actually a character from the Neptunia games, just in case you're wondering. Anyone can do it, but no, let's just send a little sister out there. Okay, the boss. Here, I got your question. What game do you like more, Doom or Halo? Okay, so. Wait. Oh. Neptune, you're the worst. Come on, you're honestly the worst sister. Anyway, I prefer a little bit more Halo. Just because I'm one of those people who doesn't really like the very gory games. Though I must admit the gameplay for Doom is actually pretty awesome. I went to my friend's house the other day as he was playing it, and it seemed like a pretty fun game. I'm talking about the fourth one of the classic ones, but I would have to say Halo. I've been a fan of Halo my whole life. Like, literally, that's one of my favorite games. But yeah, I'm actually not that much of a fan of Doom. But I'm not opposed to it. I would play it at an occasion, maybe. But yeah, I'm definitely more of a fan of Halo. Yes, go help Vert. Yes, go help Vert because I don't want you here. That's the translation of this conversation. Oh, what the heck? I think she's already used to be rejected by her own sister, that she can just do whatever she wants. Anyway, GhostHerald170 asks, do you prefer English or Japanese in the game anime? Well, I believe I answered this question just a while ago. But I do prefer more the Japanese. I don't know, I feel like they have a little bit more of a good spice of entertainment. Spice, sorry. Of entertainment in them. I'm also more of a fan of movies, animes, games within their own language of release. So I'm definitely more of a fan when it comes to this RPG or JRPG games to be more in Japanese than in English. But yeah, I'm not that opposed to English. Just that I really like the Japanese versions more. Oh, sure. By spending it later with Neptune. Sure. I bet you will get more time with her before she actually takes you out.
ついこの間までネプコに甘えっぱなしだったのに、いつの間にこんなに成長したんだか。
I believe it was since the second game? Yeah, I think since the second game. No, you know what? No, not even. I think the third game. In the second game, she was even more clingy to Neptune. Or maybe it was in this one. You know what? I don't know, Ify. I can't answer that question. I know, right? Ify has such a fatherly figure. Anyway, Kind Carl asks, what is your favorite scene in your Neptune crack? Oh gosh, Neptune scene? What is my favorite scene? Well, that's a good question! Let's see. I can't. Well, maybe the Deadpool scene from the third crack video? I thought it was a pretty nice reference there. I actually. Yes, thank you, Sumei, and not your sister. Anyway, it would have to be that Deadpool scene because of the reference in it. Which, fun fact, for those of you who want to know, I had made another clip of a Neptune and Deadpool in, like, reference, but I never included in any of the videos, so let's see if I add it for the fifth one. It would be fun. I always, in these characters, I try to combine their personalities into the characters' personalities into other characters from movies or animes. So yeah, that's a spoiler from what's coming to the fifth one. Maybe a new, another Deadpool scene. Yes, because they're taking you out of here. No, it's okay. Just because Neptune told her to, she's gonna leave right away. I told you, Vert's gonna do fine. Just keep your video games and chips. She'll do fine. Okay, another question by Miko.mc. What's your favorite intro from the Neptunia series? Okay, well, give me a second. My favorite intro would have to be actually just of the recent game that's gonna come out, the Super Dimension Neptune versus Sega Hard Girls. I am so pumped up just with that intro. It's the song is really catchy. The way that they portray the characters is amazing, and I really am enjoying that intro so much. And like I said, it's really pumping me for when the game comes out. But if we had to talk about maybe recent games, Mega Dimension Neptunia. I also like this game's intro. For those of you who tuned in when the stream started, then yeah, I really also like this intro a lot. But if I had to go for my favorite one, then the one from Super Dimension Neptune. You don't need to try your best, you just have to show your face and she'll already love you. Ah, she's gone once again. You know, in a normal person's life, this is not okay. Let's send your little sister into into helping another defeat trouble. Because I don't want to spend time with her. Oh guys, don't take any of this serious. I'm just joking here somehow. I just really like bothering Neptune a bit with this. But no, she is right what she did. Do it for the world! Oh, Ify, that happened long ago. That even happened in the anime. bird had already stole her. And even in Bird's story, she still refers to Nebula as her little sister, so don't worry, it's too late for that. What loneliness! Oh yeah, that's right. She needs no standby to notice her. Oh my gosh. Yep, that's right, Neptune. You're gonna lose your little sister just like you almost did in the anime. That's right, Neptune. It's not good. Call her back. anyway, let's see. Darcy asks, did you know Neptune and friends appear as DLC characters in Trillion God of Destruction? I actually knew about it. I read an article about that they were going to be DLCs, and I was really excited. I had never heard of the game except for when Idea Factory had spoken about them, so I was actually really excited when I heard that. I was like, oh, the characters are being presented in other games. That's pretty awesome. So yeah, I've heard about that, but I have not played the game yet, but we'll see if I get to play one day. Yes, back to Gold Stopper, show her that you notice her. Oh, Neptune. Ah, Neptune was the one who needed independence from her sister. Okay, let me just, let's do more fighting. Da-da-da-da-da. No, not this fight. Okay, let's see. Okay, so pick up Wig 16 as favorite Neptunia game. And how would you react if Neptune was in Smash Bros? Ah, let's see. Favorite Neptunia game? I think I already said it, that the first one is my favorite. But now that I think about it, I also really like Rebirth 3. So it's between those two. And this one's actually really good, but I'm gonna go with Rebirth 1. That so far has been my favorite game. The most that I have enjoyed. So yeah, Rebirth 1. And how would I react if Neptune was in Smash Brothers? I don't know. I had never even thought about it. I don't know. I would be excited, but I would also be really curious as to how they would portray her in the game, what exactly they would do, and even how people would react to that. So it would be awesome, but it's far from a dream coming true, people. Level up. I've always thought about it, but that is such a fabulous pose that Ivy does there when she levels up. Look, the little rank went up. Oh no, I remember this. I lost here last time. No, darn it. Look at all that damage. Okay, give me a second. Why are people here speaking about Donald Trump? What is this? Anyway, Black Knight 88 asks, Ladycrop, do you visited Germany? I believe I'll take this question as, have you visited Germany? Unfortunately, I have not visited Germany, though I'm not kidding. Germany was one of the places that I was really curious when I was younger. I wanted to know more about it, and I would definitely like to visit it one day. I've seen a few game shows that where they go to Germany to do some games, and it seems such like an awesome place with also very pretty places. So no, I have not gone to Germany, but trust me, I would really love to go to. I really like to go there one day. Oh my gosh, look at her eyes. Is that like a crown? Is that like a crown? It looks awesome. Let's jump. Okay, let me just be careful here. Got you. Yes, the Mad Hatter. Don't worry, I'll leave politicians out of here. I was just curious because everyone started talking about Donald Trump all of a sudden. But yeah, no politics here, people. And why, Mitchie, you're so useless, bitch! Well, Kampa's not gonna do any better either, so... By the way, Kampa, no! Cure! Okay, Adult Neptune asks, have you ever heard of Ruby from Rooster Teeth? Ah, of course I've heard of Ruby's. It's like also one of my favorite series out there. It's really fun to watch. The characters are all interesting, and I truly admire the work that the company has done to bring this anime alive. Which, by the way, for those of you who don't know, the creator of Ruby, Monty Ohm, actually died just a few years ago. So right now, the writers are actually doing the job to keep continuing the series. And so far, I honestly think they have done such an amazing job. And, well, like I said, I really like the series, so yeah, I've definitely heard of it. And in fact, I even featured some things, some references in the fourth and third crack video. So yeah, I've definitely seen Ruby, and I really like it. And I don't want to fight against that dragon creepy lizard thing, no. Okay, no, you know what? No, I'm getting out of this dungeon and call me a coward, but trust me, this thing is gonna end me! No! Oh my gosh! Oh, this is not good! No! Please do anything to defeat this! Oh, dear goodness, combat, please don't die on me right now! No. There you go, first aid. Million, please end this so I can go on with the stream. Oh, this is not good. It has another attack. Darn it. Come on, I can finish it. Okay, that's done. Thank you, Ivy. See, that's why she's the best. She just cooperated into getting that thing out of here. Okay, anyway. Yes, I'm running, people, I'm running. Okay, let's see. Pellet on Kiyova? I'm sorry, I think I said it wrong. Ask, is this Mega Dimension? Yes, it is Mega Dimension Neptunia V2. Right now, what I'm playing. And look, Miko does MC as, have you ever watched Mirai Nikki? Of course I have watched that. I've gotten to know the biggest yandere in all of the yandere animes. At least I think she's the queen of the yanderes. I don't know. I'm not sure, but yes, I've definitely seen Mirai Nikki. It's a really good anime. But it's really creepy at the same time. Like, that love that that Yuno has for Yuki is, I don't know, it could compete with Kesha's love for Noir. But yeah, I've seen it. It's a really good anime. Fun to watch. It was fun to watch at the same time. So yeah. Okay. Let's see. Yeah, I don't have much things unlocked here. Let's go to the- No! Why? Okay, let's go. Okay, Adult Neptune is asking me again if I've heard of Settle Bay Chronicles. Yes, I have. So yeah, I answered this before, I've heard of it, but I have not played it yet, but I'd be down to playing any of the games if I could have had the chance. Okay, anyway, Roaming Moon asks, do your friends like your otaku side? Ah, that's a funny question because no one knows I'm an otaku. Like I said, I don't have that many friends, but my best friends do know that I have this, severe otaku side to myself. Now, do all people know that I have it? No. No. Just my two, well, my two best friends and a few others. But no, I actually like to keep this to myself because, I don't know. It's not that I'm ashamed of it because I'm also not that otaku, as to say, but there's definitely something in me. Otome! Happy Max! Okay, so Oxys Thrill says save the game! I know, I'm gonna save it in a moment, you're right. I've been like 1 hour and a half playing this and I haven't even saved once. And just the other day I was playing in the Neptunker. And I totally got beat and all the scouts that I have found and all the levels that I have gone up just vanished just like that. So you're right, I'm gonna save the game after this. Okay, give me a second.
そこから盗まれたと思われるゲーム機やソフトが別の中古ゲームショップに持ってこられたらしいわ。
Oh great, and more stealing games. Okay, anyway, Reflect Oceans as favorite ending song in Neptunia. Favorite ending song. Let's see. So far, I think the Rebirth 2 ending song has been my favorite. Though I also like one of the ending songs of the story here in Zero Dimension. Like I said, it was this chapter before this one. So yeah, but no, definitely Rebirth 2's ending song was so far my best. As well as the anime's ending song, I also really like that one. Okay, so then why ask for it? stupid mouses, seriously. Anyway, White Demon asks, Dawn Martial Arts. Okay, well, here's the thing. Since I was very little, I really liked doing martial arts. Well, specifically just, you know, the ways that they showed it in movies, that I would just imitate them and break every single stuff in the house and get in trouble. But unfortunately, I have a fracture in my spine and I cannot do such movements as to martial arts and other extreme sports or activities. So I can't say that I have fully done like martial arts per se or taking classes. If I could, of course, then I would totally love to do martial arts, but unfortunately I'm unable to. so no, I have not done martial arts. Yes, because mouses are thieves. Have you not seen Ratatouille? I don't know if I said the name right, so I'm sorry if I didn't. Oh no, please. No, not this mouse again. Not Ratatouille. Not him again. Ladies and gentlemen, welcome back to a scene in the anime! So this little stupid rat decided to appear and bumped against Kampa. Just like in the anime. Wait for it. Yes! Could it be the same woman I fell in love from the second game? Okay, so he recognized her, that's good to know. Okay, let's see. Oh no! No, I lost the question. Okay, there it is. Ombination96 asks again, Lady Crow, what is your opinion on exercising? Exercising is really good. To be honest, I used to exercise more when I was in high school. And my type of exercising people is playing Dance Dance Revolution and Dance Central, not really going to a gym. But if you take the exercising in a fun way, then it's really good and convenient for your health. So yeah, exercising is good. I can't say that I do much of it now, but I think that's a good way to stay healthy. Well, yeah, to stay healthy. Sorry, I got nothing more. Fish your mouth! I'm gonna be honest, his love for Kampa is so disturbing, and I hope I'm not the only one who thinks this. Thank you, Neptune! I was missing the fourth wall breaking aspect of the game! Yes, it is the damn mouse from all the games! Yes, who would have thought that a mouse could do so much trouble in a game? Unrequited love. Oh, that is so true. So yeah, for those of you who didn't know who this little rat was, then yeah, he definitely, well, I don't even know to tell it for the voice, but he definitely has this utterly super crush with Kampa that is very disturbing at times. Yes, because honestly, if Kampa does fall for that thing, I'm leaving the series forever. I don't want to see that love actually come true. And please don't make any fanfiction or fan arts with these two. Are you hurt? I don't care. Sure, let's call Plutia and see if you can actually endure that brute strength. Anyway, the boss asks, Ladycroft, who would win, Doom Guy versus Chief? Well, as I said before, I have not played Doom yet. Though, from what I've seen, I don't know, it's a tough match, from what I see. I have more experience watching Master Chief survive every single damn game. So, I'm gonna say Master Chief, but it's because I don't know the Doom Guy. I would really have to play the games and see more of the story to see what resistance he has and see who would win. So yeah, sorry, I can't fully answer that question as you would like. No, she's not injured, but are you? Because I really don't care. This is honestly so disturbing. No! But Kampa, don't speak to him in that way. You're just gonna make him fall more for you. Okay, so next question is by the Marokai, sorry. Croft, will you eat a devil fruit if you had the chance? A devil fruit? No, I wouldn't. I'm not sure what that is, but no, I wouldn't eat. I wouldn't eat it, sorry. Yes, why are you here? Honestly, why are you here? Anyway, Lyrica Diva of Limbox asks, have you ever heard of Tales of Games? Yes, I believe it was Esteria or Testia. I'm sorry if I got the names wrong. I'm not exactly sure of the names again, but I've heard of the series. In fact, even once when I was buying one of the Neptunia games, I saw a collector's edition of one of the games in GameStop in the store that I went to buy it. So I've heard of the series. Unfortunately, I have not had the chance to play any of the games yet. But yeah, I've heard of it, and I might give it a try someday. Yes, please explain us why.
ゲームの転売をしにでしょ。はい、容疑者一匹確保っと。
やっぱ。
ぎゅー、な、何をする。
ぎゅ
ー。あんたが中古ゲーム店から盗んだものを転売しようとしてるのは分かってるのよ。
Yeah.
どうしてそれを。
Because the seven sages. と思
って身分証は出してないはず。
My ID.
でも犯人は絞れるのよ。それに悪事を働くネズミってのもあんたくらいしかいないしね。
Okay, so I know that I promised that I was gonna say some fun facts about the crack videos, and now that I see the time is almost 2 hours into the stream, and I have not said anything. I think so. Let me just hold the questions for just a moment, and I'm just gonna do some fun facts and references about the crack videos. And why do I want to say this? Well, because maybe to understand some of this, it would be funnier once you see the crack videos again. So yeah, let me just tell you guys a bit about them. You don't have any popularity, alright? You have all the hate on the world with me. In fact, you know what? Someone actually asked me who's my least favorite character in the Neptunia series. It would also be this little thing, okay? This mouse is so annoying and so disturbing, the love that it has for Kampa, so... Yeah, you know what? I'm actually gonna stick with this guy. No, it was definitely not the popularity, and if it was, I would've taken out the game or something. Okay, so more of the references that I included in the crack videos are here in the fourth one, because for the first one, I'm gonna admit, I believe that the first crack video is so cringy when I see it. That was my first attempt at being funny, but I don't know, for some reason I find it cringy for the things that I included, and there are a few. There are a few references that I included on it, but for example, when Ify is screaming for the no, no, no from The Office, like, oh god, please no. If you saw the anime, then you're gonna know that that's a reference into the anime when Arfuar catches her and she's torturing her into telling the where's Neptune and her plans and anything, and then she tortured her with the eggplants in the in her mouth and all that. And it's funny because at the beginning of the anime, well, in that episode in the beginning, she really loves and tells Neptune how great the eggplants are for the hell, but then after that shock, she just hates them, so... Yeah, that's one. That's one of the easiest ones. That's right, you'll get a slap in the face from me. Ew! Oh, no! I saw the face, you could have done! No! How dare you make Ivy's finger! You abomination! Oh, Ivy, I feel sorry. Oh, that stupid little rat, I told you. Yes, I do hate it. What do you mean, what's she doing? She was caught off guard. Yes, please, just get out and just clean your hands with something. Just take that off, it's so disgusting. Okay, anyway, another one of the references that you guys might have seen a lot in my videos are that I use Marvel characters into the crack videos, and this is not for nothing, okay? Like, each character that I put as a Neptunia character is because somehow they match the personality of that character. For example, we have Vert as Iron Man or Tony Stark. So, you see that Tony is a millionaire, and he also has that personality with Vert, in which they like to say that they're the best. That, in Tony's case would be his company. In Vert's inverse point of view, it would be her nation. That they say that it's the best, that it has the best technology, the best at everything. Specifically for the third one is in the anime, but then I it's funny because in the first one, I put her and Iron Man and sorry and Captain America, which is blonde, saying then take the suit and what are you? And I say me, and it's genius, billionaire, playboy, and philanthropist. We can all agree that with the genius part of Bert is right, the billionaire part is right. I mean, come on, she has the Kinect in there. The playboy, she's tried to seduce Nebula and Ivy in two games, people. Yes, she is. Philanthropist, I'm not so sure. But, yeah, that's another fun fact. We also have... Sorry, let me just continue with this. We also have blonde with Captain America. I was actually not very confident about that one. After I thought about it, I would have preferred blonde being Thor, and not just because of the hammer, because I think the personalities truly match each other. But then we have Arfwar as Loki, and the most common one, which would be Plutia as Hulk, which, well, let me just put this in quickly. Oh gosh, stop it. Oh gosh, run, kid, run. It's the abomination coming your way. So mean. Someone burned this rat alive. Anyway, what was I saying? Oh yeah, from the second crack video, we see I use Plutia with saying that don't make me angry. You wouldn't like me when I'm angry. For those of you who are wondering, that's actually a line, like a speech line from the 1977 The Incredible Hulk series, in which the character, which was Banner, that he was talking with, I think, one of the officers, or I don't remember who it was, but he actually said, like, don't make me angry, you wouldn't like me when I'm angry. And so you can see that I didn't only use Iris Hart as the Hulk while fighting Arfwar, but I also made that little reference into the old Incredible Hulk series. When in the second video, I added that line. So yeah, that's a fun fact out there. I hope the kid's okay. But no, it had to be a rat. I hate you. I mean, this is a good sign, right? At least by this we can actually confirm that Kampa is not gonna like this, and he's not gonna fall in love with that stupid little rat mouse, right? Right? Kampa, please talk and just say that he's a bad mouse. Mate! Is that Beautiful Joe? Not even, it's Bisha! It's Beautiful Joe, Neptune! By the way, look at Ivy's face! She's so done with the situation. Oh gosh. Pesto mask! What? You're not Beautiful Joe? I know you have someone saying that. That's peachy. Seriously, you're so mean. Let me just finish with this scene, because now I'm really curious and I'll continue with the fun facts and and I'll later on I'll take more questions. Serves you right, you stupid mouse. Fun fact, this song that is playing right now in the background, I was once making a drawing and I heard this song for an hour. I really liked this so much that while drawing I heard it for an hour. Ah, presto coming! How can we ever repay you? How about ask her to take off the stupid mask? A hero of justice. Okay, anyway, before I continue with the video, let's see. What other reference do I have? Okay, so in the fourth crack video, someone asked me if I like Ruby. Like I said, I really do like it. Now, in the fourth crack video, I included a line of Blake and Yang speaking. No, sorry, not Yang, Weiss. Where Blake, which in this case is Blanc, which if you have seen the series along with the Neptunia series, then you're gonna know that they have some similarities in their personalities. So when she was talking, she was making some reference that she is the next heir to the company. So in the third Rebirth game, and this is no spoilers, but Neptune goes to another dimension where there are the same goddesses are there, which is Vert, Noir, and Blonde. But in this case, Noir actually is still training to be a CPU. So you could say she's a CPU candidate somehow. In which case, in the video, she says that she's the next heir to the company. And the image that I used to put last station is actually an image of the building of the Sony headquarters in Japan. That's the top building in all of the Sony corporate. So yeah, that's a fun fact out there. And also, if you've heard of the controversy in 2011, well, where PlayStation Network went through this big hack into the servers that was not letting people play, then, well, that was not letting people play and their accounts were getting hacked. So that's why in the video I say, you hear Blake says that for its controversial labor forces, which is not exactly a labor force, but it's a controversy, you know, it actually matches with that. So yeah, that's a fun fact. And if you've also seen the anime, you're gonna notice that in episode 6 they actually make a reference to that controversy when the servers are hacked in Last Station. So did you know about that reference? I bet not. You just thought I was including Blake and Weiss in the scene. Which is not far from the reality. Aptimite of a hero! Yes, I'm chasing after that little abomination. What? Excuse me? Did you say 1,000 credits? What? What kind of injustice is this? Don't lie, I've actually played this a lot and I have like 100,000 credits, so don't lie, Neptune. Free trial? Oh, thank you. Okay, so I don't want to meet with her anymore. I don't want to give up free money. Okay. I don't want to pay her anymore. Oh gosh. The Twilight Zone! Oh, come on, Neptune! Oh my gosh! I'm just wondering, has anyone seen The Twilight Zone? It's I believe it's a very old series. But oh my gosh, come on, Neptune!
あんたもよくゲーム業界は常識にとらわれてはいけないって言ってるし
But not this way! Okay, anyway
ま、あの子らしいといえばらしいけどね
Yeah, that's definitely outside of us as they come! Anyway, speaking of Kesha, like I was doing just a while ago in the fourth crack video, well, like I said, I actually think I said this before, but yeah, the reference into her Yan Jerry mode is from the Markiplier Notice Me Senpai. That was a fun one to do, because as I was playing the game, I was so confused as to what to think of Kesha. So yeah, if you were just wondering who that random girl was there, it was just this psycho going for noirs, love and appreciation and noticing. See, now we can finally say that Noir has a friend, or rather, a really psycho-ish admirer. Yes, dude, you better run. No! No! No, Kompai, no! Leave him there! Seriously, leave him there! Why would you want to fix that thing? That's right, the policies wouldn't let it! No! Serves him right! Leave him there! I'm not trying to be mean about that now. Anyway, another reference. Out there, in the fourth crack video, there was a scene where the gang, they got into Lean Box, and Blonde says that the room seems very, very clean. However, Noir then says that she's more like she's never cleaned up. And then suddenly you see that this guy out of nowhere pops up, and he says, never cleaned up. And he takes out like a broom. And I believe the other, I don't remember what the other thing I put there was. But yeah, and then he suddenly goes psycho, like I need to clean this. That was actually Levi from the Attack on Titan anime. For those of you who have not seen it, let's just say he's a cleaning freak. And one of the things he really likes is to leave everything spotless. He likes having all the things clean, all the furniture, all the rooms. And so yeah, that's exactly why he appears in the fourth crack video out of nowhere, just wanting to clean out Vert's room. Yes, Kanba, come on. You're better than this. Come on, you're smarter than this. You have gotta be kidding me. See? Ify and I, we agree in so much things. Yeah, throw him a bone and leave him there. No, I don't think you're gonna get anything from that little thing. No, that's a terrible idea coming from Neptune. No, Ify, please! Okay, let's continue here. Another fun fact, to begin. In the third crack video, I believe it was the second or third scene that we see all the goddesses hug their sisters, the CPU candidates, and there's a very emotional music going on when they find her, and then suddenly there's Vert with no CPU candidate, all alone, just waiting for that beautiful moment to end. And then you suddenly see up in the corner of the screen, it was the right corner of the screen, you see an image pop up, and that was Chica. that was the Oracle of Linbox. Which, by the way, I remember someone asked me who was my favorite Oracle in the series, and let's see, I would have to say it's Kay. And Kay is actually the Linbox, sorry, the Oracle of Life Station, so yeah, she's my favorite. Anyway, Chica appears in that scene. She's saying, "Beresama!" For those of you who have played Rebirth 2 or NK2, you're gonna know that this girl also has an obsession with Vert. So don't worry if Vert doesn't have a CPU candidate or sister, she definitely has Chica. And you know, for Vert to be so sad about not having a CPU candidate or sister, she really likes ignoring Chica. You know what, I think I'm actually gonna do some standby scenes with Chica and Vert. That would be nice, right? I mean, it actually suits the situation. Oh gosh, I totally forgot about saving the game. Okay, this is the thing, I usually get forget the things that I'm supposed to do if I don't do them at the moment, so you're right. I'm literally gonna go save the game right now, my bad. I got all caught up in speaking here with you guys and answering questions and giving fun facts. So let me just go right ahead and save the game. Very, very quickly. Okay, Christopher Watkins, you're asking who's the girl with the crown? That would be Millian Arthur. She is a... No. Okay, she's a DLC character from Mega Dimension Neptunia. Sorry about that. She's a DLC character from Mega Dimension Neptunia. So yeah, her name is Millian Arthur. I believe I said it already. Just in case, since you were just wondering. Okay, people, I saved the game. Everything's fine now. I can die peacefully. Stupid little thing. Okay, let's go out there. Okay, this is another fun fact, and it comes from the AMV of Centuries. It was the first AMV that I've done of Neptunia here in the channel. Now, you're gonna understand this if you've seen the video in a computer. But there's a scene where... let me remember how it was. Amnesia, okay. So it says something about being immune to amnesia. Okay, for those of you who don't know, amnesia is a person who forgets where they are, their memories, any knowledge of who they are, or any sort of thing. And so, in the song, when they say that, in the music video, I added a caption that said, with Neptune saying, "Yeah, right." For those of you who are wondering why I said that, is because in the first Rebirth game, the other CPUs, they banned Neptune from the skies of game industry, and when she falls, she forgets who she is, or has any knowledge whatsoever about herself. And so yeah, I made that reference into her to her having amnesia in the first game. The guys upon you. Okay. No, nobody needs really that. Okay, so let's see. I'm gonna take again more of the questions since it seems that I have a few time left. Actually, time has gone really quickly. I only have half an hour for the stream, so let's end it with a few more questions. So if you have any more, feel free to ask them now. Out of time. There we go, we won again. Level up. Seriously, her eyes, they look so pretty. Oh, come on! Okay, so Kesha, Golfer of Last Station, is saying, "Why am I still awake?" I don't know, Kesha, but you should definitely go to sleep. Trust me. unless you're just waiting to somehow murder me or something. I don't know. Go to sleep. Okay, so Combination 96 asks, if you could kill Kyubey, would you? So, okay, if I could kill Kyubey, of course I would. I'm not gonna give out spoilers, but yes, I definitely would. I would do like someone would really in the anime like to do. For those of you who don't know who Kyubey is, even though I said it a while ago in here in the stream, he's an antagonist, or rather a villain. A villain thingy in the anime Madoka Magica. But yeah, I would definitely like to kill that bastard. Okay, so let's see. Timeus91, I'm sorry if I said that wrong, is asking, how nervous were you before the stream? I'm not gonna lie, I was actually a little bit nervous. I don't know if it was gonna be okay, if I was gonna be entertaining enough, or even if there was gonna be any people here watching the stream. So yeah, I was, darn it, I was really nervous. Not exactly as nervous as when I made the first videos, because I actually gained a little bit more confidence after doing that video, but no, I was actually more relaxed. But like I said, I didn't know if I was gonna get any audience out of this, so I was nervous, but don't worry, now I'm pretty fine. Okay, so I got confusion. You guessed it, a status effect. You will lose control of the character and they will attack allies. Oh, you have gotta be kidding me! This is no! Oh, no, come on! As if Nevgir didn't have enough noticing, now she's gonna get hit by Neptune? Oh gosh! And who got it? Million? No! Okay, I need to get these things out of the way quickly! Get them out! Okay, Kampala's use yours! Look at how cute that is. Blip. No, don't hit that thing! Stay still, minion! I would attack her if I could. Alright, I made it alive. That's great to know. Okay, just give me a moment, let me just get out of here. Oh, look at that little crown! It's going all around, it's so cute. Let's go back. Nope. Okay, let's see, Roaming Moon asks, do you have a husbando? Do I have a husbando? Oh my gosh. It's not that I don't have any. More like, which one do I say? Noble? I'm just kidding, no. No, but it would have to be, let's see, Nagisa from the anime Free. He is such a nice character, I really like him. And in fact, even my best friend knows that I really have an obsession with that guy. And he's also sexy. Come on, let's not deny it. So yeah, my husband though would be Nagisa from Free. Okay, so Oxys Thrill asks, what is your opinion on IF's Chunin tendencies? Okay, so I believe you're talking about the Chunibu. I don't know if I said it right, I'm sorry. For those of you who don't know what that is, the Chunibu is a Japanese term on when a girl, let's see how I explain it, because I'm not really sure about this, but anyway, I'm gonna try. I believe this is when a girl tends to put others below her level of knowledgement and skill. Like for example, like I said, in the first Neptunia game, the reverse one, we see that when Ivy is introduced, she really looks down on Neptune's skills as well as Compass. She just calls them little kids, and is better than them. So yes, I believe that's the right turn. If it's not, then feel free to correct me. I would really like to get that doubt out of the way. But anyway, what do I think about her tendencies? Well, they can get a bit confusing as to how I feel about her having those tendencies, but not something that's gonna stop me from liking her more than I already do. But it's funny because after she gets those tendencies, she also gets in her little tsundere mode, saying that no, that she didn't mean it in a bad way or anything. But yeah, it's definitely funny. I don't exactly mind her having those tendencies. I have got to stop winning as Neptune. I just noticed that. No, Kesha, don't watch this forever and ever and ever and ever and ever. Okay, I got it. Go! I got nothing out of XP in that. That is so sad. If you're wondering why I'm jumping a lot, it's because it's a challenge. If you jump certain times, you just complete a challenge, and it's fun. Okay, well, wait a second. Oh yes, thank you. See, Miko Duff MC says that it's a greater syndrome. Well, but it's like a syndrome that starts by that time, right? Anyway, yeah, thank you for getting that doubt out of the way. Okay, so Mike Hunt asks, question, what is the reference in the latest HPD track where Blonde is talking about Shinee or something? Oh, see, that's what I explained just a while ago. That's from Ruby. It's from... in other words, she's dissing White Shinee, who in this case is Blonde, is no R, because her nation has gotten into a lot of trouble, that they're not, that they've had controversies such as the hacked server, and yeah, that was pretty much a reference from the Ruby series to just this a little bit into PlayStation, or in this case Last Station. So yeah, I didn't really explain it to you how it's supposed to, because I gave like a full explanation just a while, but it's like dissing PlayStation. In this case, it's Wii dissing Sony. Strong enemy will appear. Oh, look, another scout! Run, pigs! Okay, if you play the first Rebirth game, you're gonna know what these little cute piggies are. Run, run! Nipko. Oh my gosh, is that the console in her hand? Cleaning robot! Okay, remember when I said that one time I got into the Neplunker dungeon and I lost, and I didn't save the game, so I lost all the scouts that I had found? Yeah, this cleaning robot was one of them. Let's see. Let me see something real quick. No, never mind. Let me go to the Neplunker once again. Okay, let's see the next question. Okay, if Comp by Ivan Garcia, if Compilar and Ida and Idea Factory allowed another company to develop a Neptunia game, who would you choose? Oh goodness. That's actually a really good question. I'm not sure, but it will have to be them, Felistella. I don't know if I said the name right, but that's the same company that has been helping Idea Factory and Compile Heart to make the new Rebirth games. Because if you guys don't know, then the first Neptunia game was actually really criticized. Like it really got a lot of hate from some critics, and it didn't do so well. But however, when Felistella helped the two companies to bring the Rebirth games to the PS Vita, they actually seemed to do better. And because, if you're wondering, it's because they did change a few things from the original story, as well as the gameplay. So yeah, I would definitely have to go with that company. If they did help in a lot, then I would definitely they have my vote if they were going to help cooperate with another NEP game. Yeah, there goes Sting. Alright. Seriously, I'm tired of seeing Neptune winning and everything. I'm actually gonna try. Look at this kill! That's bad. Seriously, I like her power a lot. That skill of hers. Don't worry, Chica. Yes, I already saved the game just like 6 minutes ago. So don't worry, it's fine. The game's so fine. No, not those little bats. Sorry, it's just that the bats in this dungeon can do a lot of damage too. What the heck just killed me? Oh, this is so unfair. Anyway, let's see, how much time do I actually have? 15 more minutes. And this guy decided to appear just at the moment. No, people, don't worry. I did save the game. I did save the game. I see a lot of comments right now that are telling me to save the game. I already did. I did like 10 minutes ago, so don't worry. I'm not dying anytime soon. Okay, ended, Million. Okay, so Chaotic Fantasy asks, how do you come up with the name Lady Croft PR? I have to say that it's the lamest thing I have ever done. Right now, I'm not really one to come up with really creative names. So, I don't know. Let's just, in the... Okay, let me explain. So, in the Tomb Raider games, specifically in Legends and Underworld, Alfred, which is Lara's, servant, he, instead of calling her Lara Croft, he calls her Lady Croft. You know, it's like an honor pick for him. I'm sorry, I just like hearing Neptune when she says that Nip-poo-poo song. Anyway, so, like I said, I'm not creative with names, so I just really like how Lady Croft sounded, and the PR, well, like I said, I'm not creative, so I just added the PR, which is from where I'm from. So yeah, that's pretty much how the name came together. Okay, so we're just gonna see one more scene. I really wanna know what's gonna happen to this stupid little rat, but I'm gonna keep taking all the questions, so don't worry. I just wanna see this last scene for you guys. No, not in the room. If you're gonna help them take him to a hospital, not a room. Seriously, get that little thing out of here. From the number 3, what are you talking about? Yes, well, actually, Kamba and Neptune, that idiot actually decided to take him. Unfortunately, Kamba. Okay, so the disturbance is right back.
いくらお人よしのコンパでもここまで入れ込むのは本当珍しいのよ。
ああ、コンパ、why?
まさかオイラってコンパちゃんにとっては特別な。
Okay, sorry. So right now I'm not seeing the comments. Just give me a break. Just give me a second. They should appear just in a moment. Oh, there we go. There we go. So the Mad Hatter asks, will you live stream again, Lady Croft? Well, first of all, yeah, don't make her sad, or otherwise I will kill this mouse. Will I ever stream again? I don't know. I mean, do you guys want to see me stream again? Like, was this fun? Like, depending, if people really want me to do another, then sure. Right now I'm really having fun. Like I said, I'm not one to speak a lot, so this has been really fun. I've never done anything like this. I've never even streamed before. Like, this is the first time I'm actually streaming right now. So yeah, this is fun. I would definitely do it if people want me to stream again. Yes, don't make her sad, stupid mousey. Criminal records. Okay, so I see that a lot of people are saying that they did enjoy the stream, then I'm happy. Right now I'm really happy. I'm glad that it's been enjoyable and that you want me to do another one, because even though I don't know how I sound right now, I don't know if I sound dull or not, or a little bit boring, but I have been smiling throughout the whole streaming right now, even with these scenes in the game, so I'm glad to know that. So yeah, maybe I'll stream another time. No, you never washed your hands! You've always been evil! Seriously. Yep, that's just making the case worse. No, please, Kampa, don't come into the scene. Okay, so Oxys Thrill says, don't do another one, just keep running this forever. I would run this forever, but I don't know. I would really like to run this even more, but I know a lot of you may have a lot of things to do, or maybe you're busy, so I wouldn't want to, I don't know, take more time into this. But we'll see. Let's see if I expand it. I mean, maybe 10 more minutes is what? It's only 5 minutes before the stream finishes. No, don't ask her, don't care. Oh, great. We have started. Seriously. Oh, Kampa. You've been telling him that for a few games already. And that's not gonna change, okay? It's not gonna change! Yes, I remember that. I don't get it. How can Kampa... I don't know, I'm a nice person, I'm kind. Usually I'm very kind towards all the people, despite if someone doesn't like me, but... How can I be nice to this mouse? Seriously! Oh gosh. Yes, please reach the end. No, you have never mentioned it, but that doesn't sound like a bad idea. Finally, some sense. Okay, so far I'm not getting any questions, just people saying do another one, shots fired, good game. What purple hearts with black heart? What is this? Which I'm just wondering, have I answered... I don't think I've answered everyone's questions, but... Did I answer your question, or... I'm just wondering, I don't want to leave anyone unnoticed. Right now I'm trying to notice everyone that I can, so just let me know. No, yes you would. Yes you would. You're asking for too much, Kampa. Okay, anyway. Chica asks again, what is your favorite what is your favorite meme? Okay, those would have to be the one from the Trolololo guy. I'm sorry, that sounded so awkward. But I don't know, that and the Rickroll ones. I find them so funny, and unfortunately I have gone through so much of them where you get this video and it leaves you with a cliffhanger, but suddenly Rickroll's song comes into the scene and you're just like, oh great, I've been Rickrolled. So yeah, that has got to be so far my favorite meme. Okay, okay, so Chris Harbaugh says my question was missed. Oh, I'm sorry. Like, try again. I'll try to answer it if I can. The Mad Hatter says, do you have a fear of spiders? I don't have a fear of spiders, but I despise them. I really don't like them. Just like this mouse right here in the screen, I don't really like the spiders. However, I don't have a fear of them. Next, internally. don't trust him, Neptune. Yeah, she has some magical power. She has the power to make everyone love her, right? A to be criminal that you would have into on an Happy Max. Yes, there we go. Neptune, how can you find that surprising? He wasn't even in the seven stages in the third game. Why would you be surprised about this? Anyway, Ellie Roth asks, will you kindly do another stream? Well, like I said, people already asked me about this, and it seems that I will. Like, right now, people seem to be liking this, so yeah. You know what? Sure, I'll do another stream maybe some other time. I don't know if you guys would like me to do any more Q&As or just me playing this. Sorry, it's just that I saw someone's comment, can we kill, please kill this mouse. But yeah, sure, I might do another stream. Like, I'm having so much fun right now. I never knew doing a stream was so much fun. And I haven't smiled a lot this week, so yeah, this is definitely something new, and I'm really liking this. I like interacting with you guys, just so you guys can get to know me better, and not just the girl who uploads every 3 months or something. Yes, everyone just saying kill this mouse. Oh, come on, Neptune. They're plotting everything. Destroy game industry? Our boys are identity. No, you can. You're a mouse. Steamax? It's 4 and another. Okay, so Guard Gamer asks, what got you into YouTube, if you don't mind me asking? Well, what got me into YouTube? Well, it really was the fact that, and you know what, I'm actually gonna tell you guys a little bit about myself. Right now, I've always really liked I really like editing videos since I was really young. Like, the moment that I discovered what that was, I was in love with it. I just like putting clips together and forming a new video, and or rather a story through them, which is what I do in the AMVs. So I used to do a lot of AMVs back in the days, and I began with Windows Movie Maker, so yeah, I had a lot of fun doing them. But when my computer broke, I lost all the things that I had done, so I just had to start from zero and just first of all, I had to get a new computer, which is the one that I currently have. And I just decided that when all the videos that I would do, I would just upload them into my channel, just to, you know, leave them there if people wanted to see them, not just specifically to start this a channel in which I could upload constantly and to gain an audience or anything like that. Just a place where I could get all my videos to, like an archive. So that's why it has been so surprising to me how the channel has turned out to be, guys. That's why I feel so happy and excited for all the success that I have been getting since I made this video. So so yeah, that's how I pretty much began. Okay, so you're an organization, but not an not an organization. What is this? Sure, blame the media.
マジコンヌのことよね。以前存在した犯罪者や犯罪組織と同じ名前だけど。
Yeah, she goes by a lot of names. そして、They do seen are for a war. All the names you could ever think about. Okay, so Blue Moon 11211 as favorite next gen form. That would have to be Blonde. I really like the way her next gen form looks. I don't know, it just looks really awesome. Same with same with Noir's, and yeah, those two. But so far my favorite one, from what I've seen, because I haven't played that part yet, but I really like Blonde's next form. Sure, stop lying. Stupid mouse. A swirl mark in it. Not sure. Please specify, mouse. Nah, it couldn't be.
なるほど。だから秘密結社はいつもゲーム機ばかり狙って盗みを働いていたのね。結局は全部外れだったっちゅうがね。
Of course you have. Anyway, let's see. Fear Genocide asks, what's your guilty pleasure game? Oh gosh. Guilty pleasure game? I don't know. Like, any of the games, they don't come surprising. Like a guilty pleasure, I don't know. I honestly don't know if I even have a guilty pleasure game. It's maybe the Neptunia games? I don't know. I mean, you see, most of the games in the market are very serious games, depending on them, such as the Uncharted, Tomb Raider, Last of Us, all those games. And then there comes this game that likes breaking the fourth wall with every sentence that it takes. So yeah, maybe the Neptunia games? I don't know. I've never thought about having a guilty pleasure game, but sure, let's just take this series in consideration. Seriously, I don't care about the rules. Wow, just wow, okay. Yes, exactly. Okay. Okay, so for those of you wondering, I'm supposed to be... Oh no, it's beautiful Joe again! For those of you wondering, I'm supposed to have ended this streaming, like, maybe, I don't know, a few minutes ago. What I'm gonna do is that I'm gonna finish this cutscene, and then I'm gonna wrap up the stream. Business call! I love how everyone says Neptune. Ping pong pong pong. See, I knew it was Bisha. I feel you could honestly not recognize her with those glasses. Oh my gosh. Oh no, actually she did. No, yeah, sorry, no, she did. I mean, they did look a little bit different in their other forms. Cyber hero organization. Bisha's a baby. Yes, that's right. I didn't know that. Oh, okay. Well, that's nice to know. I just thought she was Beautiful Joe. For those of you wondering who Beautiful Joe is, since I've been saying it for quite a while already, I believe he's a character from Capcom. I'm not sure of the game. I've only seen him in Marvel vs. Capcom 3. So yeah, and he's just, and he uses the same mask that Bisha was just wearing, so just in case anyone was wondering. Okay, so Yuke Diaz, Flittycroft, could you make some kind of a Nepu song? That would be amazing. Okay, if you're referring to another remix, don't worry, it seems like that was really successful and you guys seem to have really liked any of the Noir remix, so sure, I'll be doing another Nep song, maybe for the fifth crack video? I don't know, I'll leave the teeth here. I have an idea of what you can do with that stupid little mouse. How about you throw him into the trash and never look at him ever again? They should have burned the soul too. Steamax, you're there? Oh great. Come on, Steamax. No, why Steamax? Why? Okay, so Chica asks, do you ever think Vert will notice me? I mean, she technically does. She just... Well, you know what? I don't even know what to say anymore because she does notice you. She just doesn't care about you. It's more like a Neptune thing. But don't worry, keep trying. Just keep giving her games and anything she wants, and maybe she'll notice you one day. Yep, that's... You should not be proud of that, D-Max. Oh, why, Steamax, why? Let me see something. So it seems that a lot of people really like... They're telling right now in the comments that they really want me to do another Nep remix. Okay, okay. I'll do another one. I was actually thinking of doing the blonde one first, but I don't know. It seems like the Neptune one is winning, so we'll see. We'll see who will come out in the next crack video. Oh, this door, get out of here. If you pay really close attention, you can definitely see in Bisha's eyes that there's like it resembles Pac-Man. So you should already know, if you didn't, that Pac-Man is made by Bandai Namco. So yeah, that's why her eyes look quite different. Seriously, look at them now. They're the same. Of course, why not? Not to give out any spoilers, but... Okay, not to give out any spoilers, but I find funny how she just... out of the blue tells her, yeah, I know you, I fought against you. And then in the blonde story, Sicha is like, I don't know you, I don't know who you are. but then she reveals that she didn't know blonde, so yeah. Oh yeah, we should. Let's see. So Roaming Moon asks, do you have a favorite Vocaloid song? Yes, it's Levan Polka. The most famous one of them all, I guess. But also Laboratory, which is with Rin. Oh, and I forgot the other one's name. The one with the green hair. And just in case, I like it because of the... the rhythm, because the lyrics really took me by surprise. If you're wondering what song I'm speaking about, it's the one that appears in the Netgear Place Dance Dance Revolution video that I included. The song is called Laboratory, with like 7 V's or A's, I don't remember, but yeah, my favorite song would be Levan Polka, and I don't know if I said it right, and Laboratory. I don't want to help you. Yep, you're going, girl. You're going. Oh, yes. Yeah, thank you. It was Gomi. It was Gomi. Gomi. Yeah, that was her name. Sorry. Thank you, guys. No, it wouldn't leave any problem. It would actually be better. You should not be. Good point. yeah, that's a very good point, I see. Anyway, Ghost Harold 170 asks, will you ever call Blank flat if you met her? No, that's too mean. And I wouldn't call her flat. I think she's fine the way she is. I'm not exactly one to just call out people just because their bodies are not fully developed or I don't know. So no, I would not call Blonde flat. But I could just look out for another Neptunia character to just tell her that and see her pissed off. But no, I wouldn't call her. I don't want to die. Nope. No Neptune. No. Seriously, Neptune. Oh. Okay, guys, and this is the queue. No, wait. Let's go here. Just give me a moment. Oh, come on, all the scouts just arrived. Everybody's just saying flat is justice and that they will call Blonde flat. Seriously, you people want to die? I will not call Blonde flat under any circumstances. No! Oh no, this is not good. Oh, this is not good. Oh, no. Okay, this is gonna be very interesting. Oh gosh, it's not gonna kill him instantly. Guys, I think I'm actually gonna lose this. I'm gonna lose. Oh no! Come on, girl, get up! Oh gosh, I'm so afraid right now. I have never won against him. Oh gosh. This is not the senpai I want to be noticed by. Oh no. Ah, YOLO. No, oh my gosh. Okay. I don't know how I'm gonna do this. Things just got interesting, didn't they? Come on, Million Arthur, do something! Oh my gosh. I can't believe I'm actually gonna lose this thing. Ivy, don't die! I have to keep her alive. Oh gosh. Oh god! No! Okay, this is not gonna be good. Oh no. Okay. Let's not panic. For those of you who are saying to run, I don't think I can. Ivy? Don't fail me, girl! No! It was the wrong potion! Never mind. Okay, let's keep going. That almost did nothing! Oh, come on! Seriously, that is so annoying. I'm gonna use all the life fragments that I have. I don't want to keep... Oh gosh. You know what? I'm gonna go with this. What? Oh no. Can I run? Look at that, I can't run away. I'm actually trying to escape, people. I can't run away. This is bad. This is really bad. Okay. No. I need to keep Ivy alive. No! Oh, I can't reach her. Oh gosh, I'm gonna lose her again. Oh well. Alright, Gomba, come on. Keep her alive. Keep her alive, girl. And there she goes again. Seriously, this senpai has something against Ivy! Come on, do something! Yes! Okay, it did more damage than it should have. I'm not giving up, guys. I'm not giving up. I can still revive her 26 more times. Kampa, come on. Attack it, Ivy! No! Not Neptune! Oh my gosh. This guy really hates wasn't everything here. Okay, so far he has his half of his life down. Come on, I should be able to do this. I keep everyone alive, please. My feet, come on. Don't fail me, girl. Let's go. Okay. No! Of all the people, stop. Oh no. Okay, no, this is not good. Anyway, let's bring Neptune back to life. Okay, now, let's see. Which one was it? No. Okay. I used the wrong potion, darn it. Okay. Never mind. I love how this suddenly turned so interesting. Okay. Oh my gosh. Sword Art Online theme. Heroes never die. Neptune, stop dying. I need you alive, girl. Oh gosh, no, this is not good. Come on, Ice V! Okay, okay, okay. Bomba? You're alive too! Attacking Neptune! Oh gosh. Oh! Okay, she's alive, she's alive. Let me just... one moment. Okay, FV, there we go! Alright, let's see. No, no, wait. There we go! You're welcome! Keep her alive, compa! Come on, okay, there we go! Get your revenge, Neptune! There we go! Oh! Oh my goodness! Oh no! Oh my goodness! Come on, I can do it. No! Okay, YOLO. Oh no! Come on, million! Oh my goodness, I'm so close. But I need to keep them alive. No! Oh no! Oh no! Oh no! Oh no, wait, wait, wait! Arthur, Million, Million, where are you? There she is, okay, go! Neptune, come on! Million, come on, end him! Ah, no! Yes, yes! Yes! Oh my god, I actually did it! Oh, no! Oh my goodness! This is the first time I've won against him! Oh my goodness! Look at that XP though! Wow! Level up, girl! You deserve it! Oh my, level everyone up! Oh my gosh! I got so scared! Oh my gosh, that was... Okay, compa, you did good. Come on, you deserve to be alive. Wow, that was incredible. I can't believe I really just just defeated him. Wow. Okay. What a way to end this. Oh, okay. Anyway, guys, this has been today's stream. I honestly can't believe this. I cannot believe that I just defeated him. So yeah, this was the live stream. Thank you all so much for coming. I'm really happy you guys could be here. I'm glad you all had fun from what I have been seeing in the comments. Yes, don't worry, I'll save, I promise that. I'm gonna save the game. In fact, just let me guess. Okay, there we go. I just saved the game, so I just secured those level ups and everything. But anyways, got coming back. Thank you guys so much for coming here. I had, oh my gosh, no, he disappeared again. No, but just get some distance. There we go. But yeah, thank you so much for being here. I really had a great time. I hope you all did too. And I don't know, maybe I'm gonna have future streaming. I don't know if you guys would really like to keep seeing more of me playing, even though I didn't speak very much except for from when I was answering the questions or even the fun facts, which I still missed so many of them. But anyway, if I did miss any of your questions, then I really apologize for that. You can always just ask me in any of my social medias and I'll gladly... Oh my gosh, my voice. And I'll gladly answer them. So yeah, guys. Once again, thank you all very much. I might post this streaming later on my channel, or at least that last boss card, because that was incredible, honestly. So anyway, take care, guys, and thank you so much for being here.